So how do we stay healthy, ladies and gentlemen? Womb to tomb approach is very important. Promote healthy lifestyle and make the right decisions. And the right decisions mean correct decisions. Now let's start, we say womb to tomb. So let's start with infancy. Breastfeeding is very, very important. I'm glad that a lot of ladies in this audience. Breastfeeding your child from birth until 2 years of age is crucial. But there are not many Malaysians doing that. It's only about 20 to 30%. We are very sad by this. So we are wondering why this is happening. Because we know that breastfeeding will definitely decrease the rate of the sudden infant death syndrome, reduce the incidence of diabetes, certain types of cancers, overweight, obesity, high cholesterol and asthma in older children and adults. By eating fruits and vegetables, you can reduce the risk of strokes and coronary heart disease, type 2 diabetes, and certain cancers like colon cancer. Stay at a healthy weight. This is also very important. I'd like to make a very sad announcement. We have just realized that 2/3 of Malaysians are overweight and obese. 2/3. You see, if you look at the BMI, the conventional body mass index is 20 to 25, you're okay. More than 25, you're overweight. And more than 30, you're obese. If you follow that kind of figure, this is the figure used around the world, then about 14% of Malaysians are obese, but about 30% are overweight. But we don't use those figures now. In the Asia-Pacific region, we use a figure of 23 and 27. The younger set of Malaysian population started to smoke early in life. And of course, smoking, you all know, you can see all those horrid diagrams in newspapers about things that can happen if you smoke. But even, and it's very difficult when you start smoking, to stop smoking is difficult. Members of Parliament. Now diabetes, of course, that is going to be a big problem for us. Over the years, we have found that the incidence of diabetes has increased, and even high blood pressure has increased, and everything is increasing, ladies and gentlemen. So that is our concern in the Ministry of Health.